In this tutorial, we'll be discussing about target join 2D. So let's just look at an example. In this project, I have two logs. I have a box game object. The box game object has a rigid body 2D attached, a box collider 2D, and I have attached a jump script. The jump script will make this box jump whenever I press the space bar, and it will go left and right when I press the left and right keys. I'll just show it to you. So this is how it works. If I move right, it goes right. If I move left, it goes left. I have a plank game object. It has a rigid body 2D attached and a box collider 2D. Now to this plank, I'll add a target join 2D. I'll click on add component, write target join 2D. Press enter. You'll see that immediately there is a small plus sign and anchors that have come onto this game object. I'll run it at its default values. So it is just snapping onto its place. We'll jump on it. You see that it's a log tippy and it's always trying to come back to that square place. I'll just reduce this tippiness a bit. I'll go to the plank's rigid body 2D component. I'll increase the angular drag to say around 100 and try out again. You can see that now it's a lot less tippier. Okay, so now let's look at the properties of the target join 2D. The first property is the anchor position. So I'll zoom it up. Now there is an anchor and there's a target. So this plus sign that you see, that is a target. That is the place where this game object will try to reach to. If I have to configure that, I'll need to untick this auto configure target property and change its values. So when I run this game object will try and reach this position. So that is the target. Let's see. So you see that it tries to come to this position or the target position. I'll jump on it. So the target point that you set, that is the point where this game object will always try to reach to. The next property that we look at is the max force property. It's currently set to 10,000. The max force is the amount of force that this game object applies in order to reach to its target. So if you lower this max force to say around 10 and run it, you'll see that it has become a really loose joint. I need to increase this value a little bit, suppose 50. You'll see that it comes to its target position a little slowly. So the max force is the amount of force that is applied onto this game object in order to reach to its target position. Let's change it back to 10,000. The next property I would like to discuss is the frequency. The frequency is the amount of springiness that you want out of this game object. The higher the value you set, the lesser the springy movement, and the lower value you set, the more the springy movement you will get. So I'll run it at its default value, that is 5. You'll see that there is no special effect to it, or there is not much springiness to it. That's because of the max force. It is applying so much force that it's cancelling out the frequency. So what we can do here is, we can decrease this max force value a little bit to say 50 and the frequency to 20. Let's run it. So this is the amount of springiness that you're getting out of this game object. I'll run it once again. So the amount of springiness is decided by this frequency value. So the next property that I would like to discuss is the damping ratio. The damping ratio is the amount of movement that you want from this game object. The value ranges from 0 to 1. The max value is 1. If you set it to 1, you will get very less movement. And if you set it close to 0, you will get more movement. I'll just reset this frequency value to 5. I'll run it as it is. You'll see that there is no much springiness out of it. Now if you want good movement, you can always decrease this value to 0.1. Now you see that the movement of this game object has increased. So damping ratio is basically the amount of movement that you want from this game object. The next property I would like to discuss is the break force property. It's currently set to infinity. Break force is the amount of force that when applied to this game object makes it snap off from its target join. So currently it will not break because it's set to infinity. I'll lower this value to say around 50. So it snaps off. Let's just make this value to say 10,000 again. Set it to 1. we have all the values that we had before, but only we changed the breakforce value to 50. Now let's run it again. The spring joint breaks because the amount of force that we applied on it is too much. That is, 10,000 is the amount of force being applied on it. So it will obviously snap out of its target joint. It's a little funny. We'll see it again. You'll see that it shoots off from its target position. The anchor is this one, the one having an empty dot inside. That is the anchor. This anchor is connected with this game object, that is the plank. It's in the local space of this game object, and this is the point where the entire game object will rotate. And the target is a point in space. That is a point where this game object will try to reach. So when we click on auto configure target, both of them come to the same pivot position, that is onto this game object. But if you want to modify the target position value, you'll have to untick this and you'll have to change the value. I'll set this back to infinity. Now here, if you don't want that this game object rotates, so what you can do is, since it's a rigid body, you can obviously freeze its position Z and you can run it. You can see that now there is no rotation on this game object. So I hope guys that this tutorial about target joint 2D is clear to you.
Make sure to hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon so you get notified of the new video that I post here on YouTube. Thank you for watching.